This is a video on mathematics for the students of class 7, and we are discussing exercise 2E of rational numbers. The first term in this exercise is we are relating it to the multiplication. So far we've learned addition of rational numbers, subtraction, and today we'll be learning about multiplication of rational numbers. Now, when I multiply 7 by 6 by 9 by 2, so you see we get 7 by 6 into 9 by 2. So, I can deduct the values which we can cut or which we can simplify. Since we must remember that we can only cut numerator and denominator. We cannot cut 7 and 9. We have to cut them crossways. Okay, so numerator and denominator can only be cancelled or simplified. Since 9 and 6, they have a common factor, that is 3. So 3 threes are 9, 3 twos are 6, and no more is divisible. So we can multiply 7 into 3 is equal to 21. 2 into 2 gives us 4. So when we are multiplying fractional numbers or when we are multiplying the rational numbers, we must remember that we can only cancel the numerator and denominator. We cannot cut them horizontally, we need to cancel them vertically. Okay, now next comes simplify. Now we have to simplify this, which minimize it. It is similar to the way we solved question number 1. So minus 8 by 15 by 25 by 32. So when we multiply, so we have minus 8 by 15, 25 by 32. So 25 and 15, they have a common factor, that is 5. So 5 threes are 15, 5 fives are 25. And 8 and 32 are divisible. They have a common factor, that is 4, or you can divide them by 8 itself. 8 ones are 8, 8 fours are 32, and rest, I don't think anything is divisible. So your answer will be 5 by 12. Since we have a negative sign here and a negative sign here, so minus minus we know is positive. So this was a simple sum which explained us how to multiply the fractional numbers. Next, let us see minus 12 by 5 into minus 15. So again, 5 and 15, they have a common factor, that is 5. So you can cancel 15 and 5, so you get your 3. 12 into 3 gives us 36. Since we have the negative sign, so minus minus again becomes positive. Next question. 6 by 25 into minus 15 by 8. Minus 13 into 100 into minus 25 by 26. So what we'll do is first we'll solve within the brackets, like we know in case of Bodmer's rule. First you need to solve the values within the brackets and then operate with division, multiplication, addition or subtraction. So when you are multiplying this, so first we need to solve this within the brackets. So 6 and 8, they have a common factor 2. You can cancel with 2, 3 is 6, 2, 4 is 8. Again, 15 and 25 can be cancelled with 5. 5 threes are 15 and 5 fives are 25. So we are left with 3 threes are 9 by 20, and we have a negative sign here, so minus 9 by 20. Now we have a negative sign here. Again, we need to solve this within the bracket. So 13 and 26 can be cancelled with the table of 30, because 13 twos are 26. And 25 can be cancelled and 100 can be cancelled by 25 by 4 times. So we get minus 1 by 8. Now minus, when we remove this bracket, it becomes minus, minus becomes plus. So we have minus 9 by 20 plus 1 by 8. Since we see that both are unlike fractions, so we need to make it like fraction. For that, we need to find out the LCM of 20 and 8, that is 4. 0, so that is 40, and then minus 9 into 2, 20 into 2 gives us 40, so you are multiplying the numerator with 2, plus 1 by 8, so we need to multiply 1 with 5, so you get minus 9 into 2 plus 1 into 5, that is minus 18 plus 5 by 40, so your answer is minus 30 by 40. Next question, number 6. Find the distance covered by a car in 2 by 5 hours at a speed of 46 2 by 3 km/h. So we have been given time, which is 2 by 5 hours, that is 12 by 5 hours, and speed given is 140 by 3 km/h. Now we know that distance is equal to speed. 40 by 3 into 12 by 5 will give you 112 kilometers. So this is the distance that will be covered by the car. Now coming back to multiplicative inverse. Now we have read about what is additive inverse. Now in case of multiplicative inverse, let us see what happens. Now we have 5 by 6. Now what will be the multiplicative inverse is, we'll just interchange the numerator and denominator. So 5 by 6 will become 6 by 5. Now suppose we have a negative number in the place of numerator. So minus 3 by 7, the multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 7 will be, the negative sign will remain in with the numerator. Only the numbers will interchange. So it will become 7 by 3. Now if you have a single number and not a rational number like just 8. Suppose you have your minus 8. Now we know that if you do not have any number, if you know that means you have 1 out there. So what will be the inverse of that number will be 1 by 8. Since we have a negative sign, so it continues to remain there. So this is what is multiplicative inverse. This is all we have from the exercise today.